What are Hindus' views on terrorism?
How do we view terrorism? Terrorism in the name of religion comes because of exclusivism. Because when any one religion makes a claim, oh, God, I'm on God's side and God is on my side, and if you don't agree with me, I'll kill you or I'll convert you. This produces terrorism or fighting in the name of religion, exclusivity. Now, unfortunately, I have to be very frank, the Abrahamic tradition are exclusivist by nature. They'll all say Judaism, Christian, Islam, will say this is the only way, you are all, the rest of you are wrong, or perhaps completely wrong, or partly wrong. So they'll fight, saying that God is on our side, if we are on God's side, we are fighting for God. And this gives them fanatic kind of, if they become fanatics, because religion is a very emotive subject, and it's easy to produce fanatics. And this is why, in the name of religion, you see so much terrorism going around the world today. This is the biggest threat the world faces today, is terrorism in the name of religion. And the reason is exclusivism. And the Indic tradition, not only Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, Sikhism, Hinduism are inclusivist, not inclusive. They are pluralistic by nature. They don't mind. You say, you don't believe in me, good for you, go for your own way. We will not interfere. We will not impose ourselves on you. You want to unfold spiritually in the way that you like, go for it, my friend, go for it. This is why Hinduism looks at terrorism saying, what a foolish idea. It comes out of because of exclusivist claims made by certain religions, and this has to be challenged and put on the back burner if you want peace on this earth. It will happen in this decade. It won't be sorted unless people give up exclusivism. It cannot be sorted out.